Open your third eye. Focus. What do you see?
I've been over this intro like a million times and I can't get it right, so I'm just gonna say it. I've had a
premonition dream.
What is it? What is that? What do you say? You don't know what that is? What is defined, specifically defined a premonition dream? Oops.
A premonition is a vision, a gut feeling, or another experience that grants you knowledge of things that haven't happened yet.
That sounds like dumb poo-poo. Because it is. I'm not a superstitious person. I would sooner go and re-damage my ankle than go and see a psychic for my own personal benefit. But I will admit that some dreams do have some meaning behind them. Like how I can be stressed in real life about money, and then I'm feeling and experiencing the same thing in a dream, but the only difference is that I can fly and my dad is Santa.
Oh.
There's some connection between the real world and the dream world there. But to be able to tell the future in a dream? That just doesn't make any sense. So why am I here claiming such things? As having a premonition dream? Because I don't really know any other way to explain it. Okay, so here it is. We fade in. It's me. The year was a couple years ago. The place, basement. I've been playing Mario all day, and I was doing very well for myself, almost completing the entire game until I hit one castle level that was a little bit harder than average. There was no checkpoint in this level where I really needed it, so I did what anybody else would do after playing Mario for 10 hours. I went to bed. And you know when you do like one thing all day, almost obsessively, and then you go to bed and you end up dreaming about it? Well, that's what happened to me. And that night, I dreamt of Mario. It was me in that castle level again. The sensation was as if I was watching myself play. The level was exactly the same in the dream. There was this brown snake block thing that you had to ride through the level. You are tasked to stay on top of it without jumping off into a bunch of spikes. And while doing that, you're also responsible for dodging all of these spike balls. And then the snake approaches this hole, and it goes down the hole, and you're supposed to get off and continue the level. And that's where it would have been really nice to have a checkpoint. So the level would have been easier. Manageable. But in my dream, it starts to go down, and I don't get off. I watch as I descend into the pit. I should be getting off, but I don't. And as common knowledge goes, this is where Mario would die. But in my dream, the camera followed down the hole. Very unexpected. Did not expect it. I didn't expect it. But there I was, descending. And at the bottom, there was a door and a checkpoint. Which is exactly what I needed! But it was a dream. The next day, I get up and I go try to play again. At this moment, I remember the dream. And I don't know why I tried it, but I decided to copy what happened in my dream. I bet you can tell where this is going. I tried the dream thing in real life and it worked!
What?
And now the level was gonna be a ton easier. There's a couple of ways this could have happened, but one sec, let me paint you some perspective. That's like you having a dream of you finding a secret box in your attic that you've never seen, and it has like cheese in it. Maybe M&M's. Doesn't matter. You go and try to see in real life, and it's actually there. Like, how do you explain that? How do you explain that? How are you gonna do it? How are you gonna do that? I can't. That's what happened to me, and I know I can't explain it. Perhaps you wonder. This was all my unconscious mind telling me something from what I saw earlier in that day in my dream. Well, let me tell you, as
the new seer of the universe.
No, it wasn't. Did I look at a walkthrough or cheat sheet? No. Did I get tips or advice from my friends or family? No. All I did that day was play Mario and eat and then sleep. And ignoring the sad undertone of that day plan, I had no exposure to anything that would hint my subconscious to tell me that in the dream. Either I have an actual third eye, or that was a million and one coincidence. Who's gonna be the judge? Us. Right now.
Non-stop, like,
oh,
roll it.
Okay. Why?
Because it's like...
I have
20-sided dice, I got 6-sided dice. You can look at the dice.
I'm zooming in on your forehead quick.
You got...
Ooh.
Many dice.
And a coin.
This is 2-sided dice. Heads.
It's tails.
3.
It's a 6.
It is a 6. This one's 20-sided.
Okay.
So I'm just gonna choose... You can look at my face, by the way.
I refuse.
Let's do, like, 15.
Okay.
So, 6. Wait, how many sides did it have?
It was an 8.
Oh, 2. That's pretty close.
You're at like 0% right now.
Yeah.
That's not very good.
No. I forgot to guess.
Oh my god. No, don't go back to the coin. You've already failed the coin.
I like the coin because it has higher odds.
No.
2.
No, we didn't.
Ah! What are the chances? It's zoom in on my face.
It's already zoomed. Oh, wrong way.
It didn't work.
Yeah, you were blurry.
It didn't work. That's a route.
In the end, I beat the level with a new checkpoint and went on to beat the rest of the game. I still don't believe in psychics or fortune tellers or this guy, but that dream, it raises questions. Thanks for watching. Check out this other video that I have. And if you do, then I will appear in your dreams and we can hang out, but I will not stop farting.